China is becoming a force to be reckoned with as far as space exploration is concerned. Yes, it is still lagging behind the US, but it's not too far behind. There have also been talks about some of these developments being copied from Elon Musk's SpaceX and NASA itself. How accurate are these allegations and how well is China actually doing out there? Find out in this video, but before we begin, please consider subscribing to our channel for more content like this in the future. By the end of April 2021, China celebrated its National Space Day. During the event, China basically highlighted its recent achievements in space and technology. It has to be said that the successes are no joke. We all know that NASA recently landed its Perseverance rover on Mars, although it has landed a total of 5 rovers so far, only 2 are still working. On the other hand, China has also landed its first rover on Mars in May, making it the 3rd nation to do so after the US and Russia. In 2019, China became the first country to land on the far side of the moon. Just before this National Space Day, they had managed to bring back samples from that side as well. The purpose of National Space Day was to create more interest in younger generations for aspects like space exploration. By highlighting its very recent achievements, China seemed to have done a decent job there, aspiring the younger generations to take a keener interest in this area. Will help ensure that China doesn't continue to lag behind the likes of NASA and SpaceX in the future. There have also been some exciting developments in this field because it's being observed that there are many similarities between the future transportation system of SpaceX and that of China. To understand that, we must go back to 2017 when Elon Musk's company, SpaceX, announced its plans regarding the Starship. The Starship system is essentially a fully reusable, two-staged orbit super heavy lift launch vehicle currently under SpaceX development. The concept laid down in 2017 basically highlighted the aspect of transporting something from one end of the Earth to the other in a matter of minutes. The video posted by SpaceX itself and YouTube highlighted how the travel times between two far-off locations could be cut down to minutes. The flight time from Shanghai to New York was mentioned as just 39 minutes. Similarly, Hong Kong to Singapore was mentioned as just 29 minutes. More examples included the flight time of Los Angeles to Toronto, which was coded at 22 minutes. In the same way, imagine flying from London to New York and London to Dubai in just under 29 minutes. Remember that this system published as far back as 2017 constituted a rocket taking up from a horizontal surface, launching itself into space and then landing back on Earth on a flat surface again. If you have been following SpaceX news regarding this, you would also know that the company had several failures when it was trying to test the launch of its Starship rocket. Due to malfunctions and other unanticipated errors, the rocket burst into flames as soon as it took off. Although it was quite a setback for SpaceX back then, they've already successfully incorporated new changes and are en route for that perfect Earth-to-Earth transportation system. Interestingly enough, China announced similar plans in 2021. When I say similar plans, I mean a similar shaped rocket with the same design. The purpose was also pretty much the same, the vertical takeoff from horizontal surfaces and landing vertically at horizontal surfaces. Before this, the rocket flies into orbit and then returns back to Earth. It is important to understand that this particular system announced by SpaceX was one of its kind and was something never done before. So the fact that a couple of years into their announcement, China announced exactly similar plans was suspicious, to say the least. The China Academy of Launch Vehicle Technology, a booth operated by China's main state-owned rocket manufacturer, announced China's plans while highlighting the potential for suborbital point-to-point transportation. This is essentially a concept in which a vehicle launches from Earth into suborbital space and touches down halfway around the world in less than an hour. Reminds you of something. That's right, SpaceX's Starship rocket and transportation system. The promotional video captured and shared on the Chinese network Weibo showed the two different concepts for achieving suborbital passenger flights. Remember that this is only planned for about 2 decades from now. It had the same stainless steel structure and triangular aerodynamic fins. The first and the second stage of the rocket were also seamless. All of this was essentially exactly the same as its American counterpart. The striking resemblance between China's system and that of SpaceX did not go unnoticed by anyone. But China did not seem to offer any explanations regarding that, and it just portrayed how keen it was to get ahead in the space exploration race. Interestingly, the video on Chinese media also highlighted the second concept of point-to-point transport. This included the video concept of an object taking off horizontally instead of vertically. Similarly, a horizontal landing vehicle was shown, which used a type of electromagnetic catapult. What China did here was it stated that these two systems are an integral part of their goals to establish point-to-point transportation in the world by the year 2045. Keeping that in mind, let's take a minute to talk about Ling Space. Ling Space Aerospace Technology Incorporated is essentially a Chinese private space launch company based in Beijing. The company is led by its CEO Hu Zhenyu and was founded as the first private rocket firm in China. The same company has also developed a rocket called Line 1. Interestingly, Hu Zhenyu has publicly stated that the company looks up to SpaceX and aims to follow its path in space exploration. The Line 1 rocket was also developed essentially follows the footsteps of its American counterpart, which is SpaceX developed. Here's what the CEO of Ling Space said. SpaceX is very cool, and Falcon 9 is extremely great. We take SpaceX as our goal and guide, because there are many advantages for us to learn. The Line 1 rocket will have only a single reusable stage, and the company tends to think big and aims to develop a second stage that could also be reused after landing. This is of course a long-term goal, but who hopes that it could be implemented after the company's first launch vehicle? Just like SpaceX, Ling Space does not exactly have the backing of its country's government and is run independently. However, they do hope to excel enough in the future to be able to get international contracts on a commercial basis. They are also showing their keen interest in getting the Chinese government on board one day. So why is China going out of its way to essentially walk the same path as the American company SpaceX? It wasn't too long ago that SpaceX was being labeled as a huge waste of resources, even if they were private resources. Now that SpaceX has partnered up with NASA and actually seems to be going somewhere, it's being considered a power on the same level as NASA. The fact that the Chinese are trying to implement the same designs and the same goals as that of SpaceX speaks volumes about it. As for why China has these ambitious goals is because the space transportation industry could become a very, very huge thing in the future. SpaceX and China now not only aim to transport materials through space and back to Earth, but they also intend to transport humans somewhere in the future. The current timeline shows that this could happen somewhere around 2045. The development of space technology is said to be currently worth $400 billion right now. According to experts, the number could go up to $800 billion as soon as 2030. How high it will go once both Americans and Chinese are transporting humans through space, I leave that to your imagination. No wonder China wants its share in this emerging technology. So that's about it for today, folks. Hope you enjoyed the video. Do subscribe to our channel to view similarly amazing videos on your feeds. Oh, and don't forget to hit the bell icon to receive an instant notification from our side. Till next time, folks. Bye.